Hello children, welcome to Narayana Live Classes. Today I am going to explain key of 23rd November 2020 dated assignment solutions. This assignment related to direct and inverse proportions. Let us move on to the assignment. See, the first question is, complete the following tables given that x varies directly as y. So here x varies directly as y means x is directly proportional to y. We know that if two quantities are said to be in the directly proportion to each other, if one quantity is increasing, its corresponding quantity will be also increasing. So which means here x is increased, then y is also increased. If x is decreased, then y is also decreased. And we know that the relation between x and y is, x is directly proportional to y means x is equal to ky. Okay. Here x is directly proportional to y. Directly proportional to is denoted with y. Okay, if x is direct proportional to y, that implies x is equal to ky, which means x by y is equal to k. This is the formula. You two quantities here, x and y are variable quantities, are said to be in the direct proportion, then x by y is equal to k. See here, the first question is given. In the first column, x is equal to 2.5 and y is equal to 5. X is equal to 2.5, here given x is equal to 2.5 and y is equal to 5 given. From these two variable values, we can find the k value first. So what is the k value? That implies k is equal to 2.5 by 5. 2.5 ones, 2.5 twos, k is equal to 1 by 2. So this formula, this is a substitute here, then x by y is equal to 1 by 2. X by y is equal to 1 by 2. Now we got the formula x by y is equal to 1 by 2. By using this formula, we can find the missing quantities. See, in the second column, x is the missing value, y is 8. Here, x is the missing value, y is 8. We need to find the x by x value. Here, given y is equal to 8. See, y is equal to 8. The first column is x missing column by y value given 8. Is equal to, already we have 1 by 2. When you will do the cross multiplication, that implies x is equal to 8 by 2. This 8 will be transformed to the right side. Is equal to 4. So that implies x is equal to 4. So here we can write, what is the x value? We can write the 4. In the same way, in the third column, see, the missing value is x again, y value 12. So in the third one, second one, see, given y is equal to 12. So this is substitute again in this equation. You will get x by 12 is equal to 1 by 2. This 12 will be transformed into the right side. X is equal to 12 by 2 is equal to 6. So we can write in the third one, x is equal to 6. Now the last column, see, given x is equal to 15, missing value is 5. So how you can find x value given 15? So in the third one, see, x is equal to 15 given, y is missing value. So what is x by y? Is equal to 1 by 2. So 15 by y is equal to 1 by 2. So when you do the cross multiplication, y into 1, y is equal to 15 into 2. So y is equal to 15 twos are 30. So you can write here y value 30. Okay. Now see the second box. In the again here also x is directly varies to y. X value 5, y value 8 given here. See that. In the second box, x is equal to 5, y is equal to 8 given. Okay, x is equal to 5, y is equal to 8. From this, we can find that we know that what is the relation? X is directly proportional to y means that implies x by y is equal to k. X by y is equal to k. So, x means 5, 5 by 8 is equal to k. This k value substitute in this equation. So, that implies x by y is equal to 5 by 8. This is the our formula. By using this formula, we can find the missing frequencies. Come to here, what is the first missing frequency? X is missing value, y value 12. We need to find the x value, find. Y is equal to how much? 12. So, x by first one, y value 12 is equal to 5 by 8. Why the y value 12? Given y is equal to 12. That's why I substitute the y value in this formula. So while doing the cross multiplication, x into 8, 8x is equal to 12 into 5, 60. Then x is equal to 60 by 8. 4 2s are 4, 15s are 15 by 2, nothing but 7.5. So here 7.5 I got it. Now in the same way, x value 10, y value missing frequency. Here second one, x is equal to 10. Then what we can do? 10 by y is equal to 5 by 8. While doing the cross multiplication, 5y is equal to 10 8s are 80. Then y is equal to 80 by 5. So 5 1s are 5 16s. So y is equal to 16. Here y is equal to 16. Next x value 35. X value 35. X is equal to 35 given. That implies 35 by y is equal to 5 by 8. 5 by 8. Then cross multiplication you will do, 5y is equal to 35 into 8. That implies y is equal to 35 into 8 by 5. 5 is multiply with y, transform into the right side, will divide. 5 ones, 5 sevens, therefore y is equal to 7 eights are 56. So here 56 we can write. Next, x value 25 given. Next one, x value 25. X is equal to 25. So this is substitute in this formula. 25 by y is equal to 5 by 8. 5 by 8. So when you doing the cross multiplication, 5y is equal to 25 into 8. 25 into 8, then y is equal to 25 into 8 by 5. 5 ones, 5 fives, then 5 eights are 40. 5 eights are 40. So here when x value 25, y value 40. So the last one, now x is again missing. X missing, y value 32. See that last one, y value 32. Given y value 32, what is the x value? We know that x by 32 is equal to 5 by 8. Now we'll do the cross multiplication. 8x is equal to 32 into 5. Then x is equal to 32 into 5 by 8. Then 8 ones, 8 fours are, therefore x is equal to 4 5 is 20. Okay, so finally here x value we can write the 20. Okay, so these are the direct proportion sums. So mainly if x directly proportional to x varies to the y, directly varies to the y means x by y is equal to k. So first you have to find the value of k. Afterwards by using this k value you can find the remaining values, children. Okay, so let us move on to the second sum. C, an electric pole 14 meters height casts a shadow 10 meters. One electrical pole is 14 meters height, shadow length is 10 meters. Okay, second one, for example this is the electrical pole, shadow will be on the ground, shadow will be on the ground. So I will draw the one triangles here. See that ABC, shadow and electrical pole always perpendicular to each other. Electrical pole height is 14 meters, its shadow length is 10 meters, its shadow length is 10 meters. So this is the shadow, this is the pole, electrical pole, electrical pole height. So electrical pole 14 meters and its shadow is 10 meters height. At the same time, see what happened. At the same time, find the height of the tree that casts a shadow 15 meters under similar conditions. Here cast a shadow 15 meters a tree. See this here. At the same time, shadow of the tree, this is the tree and shadow, same time. So in the same time, under the same conditions, we need to find the what is the height of the tree, that is the condition. So observe here, the height of the object is directly proportional to the length of its shadow in the same time. If height is increasing, then length of the shadow should be increasing. If height is decreasing, then length of the shadow will be decreasing. That means here what we can conclude here, height of the object is directly proportional to shadow. So that point, height of object is directly proportional to length of shadow, that is the condition. So which means here 14 by 10. So for example, this is the height, this is the shadow of the length, these are directly proportion. So 14 is directly proportional to 10 means 14 by 10 is equal to k. We know that x is directly proportional to y, x is directly proportional to y, then x is equal to k, x by x is equal to ky, then x by y is equal to k. By using that formula, 14 by 10 is equal to k. But in the same conditions, coming to here, what is the height and length of the shadow is 15, is equal to k value, I got 14 by 10. Now while doing the cross multiplication, what you will get, 10h is equal to 14 into 15, then h is equal to 14 into 15 by 10. 5 2s, 5 3s, 2 1s, 2 7s, so 7 3s are 21. Therefore height of the tree is equal to, therefore height of tree is equal to, how much I got, 21 meters. This is the height of the tree, second sum solution. Okay, so let us move on to the third one. If the weight of 12 sheets of thick paper is 40 grams, weight of 12 sheets of thick paper is 40 grams, how many sheets of the same paper would weigh 2.5 kilograms? Here weight and number of seats and weight of the papers. See, I will write the solution here. Number of seats directly proportional to weight. Number of seats directly proportional to weight. So here, what is the number of seats here? 12 seats. Okay, x is proportional to y. That implies x by y is equal to k. We know. So in the same way, for example, number of seats x, then weight is y, then x by y is equal to k. So here x means 12, weight is how much? 40 grams. 40 grams is equal to k. So this is the k value. Afterwards, how many seats of the same paper, would have the weight in second situation, in second case, what is given? We need to find the number of seats. So number of seats is equal to x. Weight is how much given? Weight is given 2.5 kilograms. 2.5 kilograms, 5/2 kilograms. Kilograms will be converted into the grams, because in the first case 40 grams given. So here also we need to convert into that 5/2 kilograms, convert into that 5/2 × 1000. So 5/2 × 1000, 1 kilogram is equal to grams. So 2 ones 2 500s, that is equal to 2500 grams. Okay, so in the second case, number of seats x. Now apply in this formula, k value, what I got? X value x only by number of weight is how much? 2500 is equal to k value. Already we find 12 by 40. So let us do the cross multiplication. 40x is equal to 12 × 2500, then x is equal to 12 × 2500 by 40. 0, 0 cancel, 4 ones 4 threes, then x is equal to 3 × 250 is equal to 750. So number of required seats, how many seats I got? 750 seats. Okay, children. So these are the assignment solution. Thank you very much.